Hello guys, hi, another video. Now I already told you in the last video what I'm going to do for this video, and I used all the products that I bought, and as you can see I'm wearing this choker that I bought, and with my top, you know, you can see it's looking quite pretty. And this is the look I created using all those products, right? So I did a haul video in the last one was the haul video, and I told you in that video that I'm going to use all these products in the next video. I used each and every product I bought from Nykaa as well as from Cubs and Lashes, and I created this look, right? So if you want to see how we did it, let's go. But before, subscribe, like and share. Now I am going to start the clean face with literally nothing on, and we are actually going to start with the eye cream, right? So let me take this eye cream from Biotic. This is the Biotic Bio Seaweed Fatigue, kind of something cream. This comes pretty protected. It's like you have to put this out. This does smell very Ayurvedic. Now this has a protective lid, and I am actually going to put it under my eyes. Now I'll let this sit for a while, actually. Let this sit, and then I shall move to the cream, the Lactocalamine Daily Face Care Lotion. Now it's very important to moisturize your skin because you don't want your makeup to harm you. So I'll take very little quantity because I think it's not important to use too much. It's already so hot. So all on my face. This says oil control, but this is for normal skin, so it only absorbs all that necessary oils and nothing like more than what you need. We will let this sit for 5 minutes. Now we will prime our face, and because I have bought this three in one primer, so we are going to use this. Let's give it a good shake. And now let's be honest, it smells really good. It has such a sweet smell. Now I think I have used too much. I have no idea. This is a primer. I don't know how it can be both a primer and a setting spray. I'll let this dry for a while. Now this has settled down already, so we can start with our foundation. Now because I bought this foundation stick, we are going to use this. Now let me tell you another thing. I have this brush set. These pink ones are the ones I recently bought from Flipkart. So these are absolutely new too. So it's like all with new stuff kind of video. Now I am just going to put a little. It's pink. So I did not want to have the pink one, but I still got the pink one, and okay, fine. This is not my shade, although, but we'll make it work. Now I wanted to know if it works both with Beauty Blender and brushes. So we are going to do like a half side with brush and half side with Beauty Blender. So let us start with the Beauty Blender first, and let's see if it blends seamlessly. Now with brush, I'm using a black tip brush for this. Let's just see if it blends better with brush or with Beauty Blender. I'm finding it difficult to blend with the brush. I think it was much easier to blend it with the Beauty Blender than to blend it with the brush. And I think this is actually giving me a very ghostly kind of appearance when used with a brush. I'll go with my Beauty Blender. So I'm going to use this again as my concealer. I'm going to use my Beauty Blender, and I'm just going to take some product out of this and go in. humidity, I think, I don't know why, if it's really hot or maybe it's because of this, but you can definitely see how greasy I'm getting. So let's just move quickly to the compact, and I'm going to use this Maybelline one, and I hope this saves me today. Now I am going to use my brush, my powder brush. I am only going to put this powder only on my entire face other than my eyes, because I have another product that I'm going to use for my under eyes. I don't like it at all. This face looks so bad. Now let's move to another product. My favorite. Now I'm literally opening this in front of you. Now I am going to use this type of brush that has this dome shape. I'm going to take this powder and put it under my eye. Wow, this has definitely given me a lightening effect, and I am going to set my lid with this too. I think this is pretty good. Wow, this literally mattified the entire eye area, and I'm liking this. Now we are going to contour the face again using the same Wet n Wild palette that I used for highlighting. I am going to contour my face. I'm going to use this angular kind of brush. If you could see, this is angled like this, and this kind of angle is good to reach the hollow of your cheeks. Now contouring is very important if you want to give your face a 3D-ness, because right now my face just looks like a ball. Have that dimension. As you can see, definitely this product has some pigment, and I am just going to blend it quickly because we need perfectly blended and carved out cheeks. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it. This, I say, if you want to have a chiseled, perfectly chiseled as well as highlighted face, go for this. This is very important. I don't have the blush because I don't really use blushes. So we are going directly to the highlighters. Now one of these actually has a greenish kind of finish, and the other one has the pinker one. So first of all, I am going to use the pink one. This is that one. And this is color number 3. So if you want to buy this, you can definitely see that. And I am using this type of brush, taking all the excess off, and we are going to put it on my Can you see it has this pink shift? Now honestly, this foundation, oh my god, it's making me sweat so bad. I look so watery right now, and I don't know why, but this is happening to me. Now, should I go for the green one? For the other hand, other side of my face, I'll go with the green one. I'm going to quickly take it dust back. Really nice. Pink hair, green hair. I love it. So I think these two are perfect, and for ₹55 and ₹40, it's a good buy, right? So you can definitely check this out. Now let's quickly move to the eye makeup, and I am going to use what I want to use. And oh my god, I'm so sweaty and I'm not liking it at all. I think we can have pretty elaborated kind of look. Now I'm going to use a fluffy brush, and I will use this shade over here. You know, can you see this shade? This is the shade I'm going to use, and I am quickly going to put it on my entire lid. After this shade, I'm going to use this brown color. Quickly, I'm going to use this brown color, and again on the entire lid. Let's give it a brownish to this. Now these are pretty pigmented, I must say. These are quite pigmented. I'm liking their pigment. And definition of her eyes, I think this looks pretty good. Now I am actually going to go with a pop of color. I am going to use this magenta shade over here. It's more like a cranberry kind of shade, and I'm going to take a fluffy brush. Can you see the pigmentation? Oh my god, it's literally coated the whole brush. And we are going to put it here in the edge of my eye. Now initially you don't have to really worry about all that blending. You can blend that later with the brush you used earlier for your transition shades. Again, in the pretty good palette. Now I'm going to take the same brush again, and quickly we are just going to blend it seamlessly into the crease. Right, make sure you actually put same quantity of eyeshadow on both the eyes. It should not look like you have more on this eye and lesser on this eye. So make sure about that. If you feel you are lacking color somewhere, just use more color. Add it step by step rather than putting it together all at once. Okay? Take a densely packed brush, and I am going to quickly take this makeup fixer. Give it a good spritz with this fixer. You know, it's good to wet the brush first. And I am now going to take a shimmer shade. I think I'll use this one over here, and we are going to quickly take it. Use my finger for this. I am simply going to take the shadow and put it all across my lid. You know, see, finger definitely works better. Just put it there. Then all you have to do is take your blending brush and blend it out. You know, just blend all the color you have put in together. Wow. Now honestly, I am pretty happy with the way these shadows are working. I was not expecting them to be these colorful, because I was pretty skeptical about this. Now I am going to darken this crease again using the same cranberry shade I used earlier, because my crease was actually lacking a bit of color. So going out, don't worry, even if you lose that mark sometimes, you can always fix it. Now, going with eyeliner, I was very excited for this eyeliner as well, because this is said to be like copy for the Stay Quirky one, and Stay Quirky one is pretty, pretty legit. So give it a shake. It's so fine, so thin. I'm loving it already. Dip to complete the brain. I must say it's a pretty thin eyeliner, so it's really easy to make a very precise, soft kind of wing with this kind of liner. You can see exactly where your brush is going, and I am loving it already. I'll quickly finish this eye and I'll be back. Using this Nykaa kajal, we are quickly going to put the kajal in my eyes. I think it's pretty black, and if it lasts for quite some time, then I think this is a good kajal. You can see the tip of this kajal is very pointy, unlike the other kajals we buy from the market, and these type of tips work better for application. Now we are going to complete the lower lash line quickly, taking the same cranberry shade. I am going to smoke the lower lash line. Another such brush, and I am actually taking this white color to highlight my brow bone, to give I think the eye is pretty complete, and I'm liking the way this eye look has turned out. I was not really sure if it's going to work, but I'm happy it did. Now moving on to mascaras, I have two mascaras with me. I'll quickly take this one out. I'm going to put one on this eye, one on this eye, so we can quickly see which works better and if they really even work. So taking the ADS Colossal mascara, it has such a huge one. Now I'll take this to my right eye and I like it. So far I like it. Now I must say it's difficult to work on the lower lash line because it's a pretty thick wand. So for the upper lash line, this is pretty workable. Now going to the Me Now mascara. This one too, I think both of them are working pretty same. They have given my lashes the same volume whatsoever. But because the wand is pretty sleek, it's easier to work on the lower lash line. I am going to prefer this one over the ADS one because of course it's better and easier to work on the lower lash line. We're pretty much done with the entire face. The only thing left is the lipstick now, because I have just one lipstick with me, so I am going to use that. The color of this lipstick is exactly what I love. I love these kind of nude colors. But I think for my skin tone, this is more like a very light color. I usually prefer the darker ones, so but otherwise also I think it's a pretty nice color. Now the last thing to do is the setting spray. We are quickly going to use the last setting spray that we have. We have used pretty much all the products other than the one that I got for free, so I think I'll use that in some other video. Let's quickly give the spritz and let's quickly give it a quick fanning. Oh, this is the final look that I created using all the products that I bought from the haul, and I think let's take a quick sneak peek from what I loved and what I did not love. Now I think this is a pretty good setting spray, and so is the other setting spray. I love the setting sprays. I loved the mascaras. I loved the palette that I was using. I loved the contour. I loved the Wet n Wild contour as well as the highlighter. I loved the Maybelline compact. The only thing that I did not like in this entire thing was this Olivia foundation. I think I would rather leave this kind of product next time. Then what I bought from this entire thing, I'm loving everything. You can definitely check all these out. I am going to link everything in the description box. And if you love this look, do give a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, share this. And if you loved the way I did this makeup, please do tell me. I love to know personally how you felt about everything. And so, yes, that's a wrap to this look. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.